sonic time capsule has been unearthed, revealing a lost chapter of Bay Area music history. Juliet Goodridge on The Moment, the man in black crossed paths with an infamous sound engineer in San Francisco.
They used to record music on reels like this, using long, narrow strips of magnetic tape. It's amazing something so fragile could hold so much Bay Area history. On the corner of Market and Van Ness in San Francisco, a huge building currently houses the Van Gogh exhibit. More than half a century ago, it was home to a dance palace known as the Carousel Ballroom. During the 60s, on the second floor, the Bay Area flocked to hear rock music. But on one evening in 1968, hundreds of hippies gathered and they heard this. That's the great Johnny Cash. The date, April 24th. While no photos exist, the event was recorded on audio tape.
I'm gonna sit right here until I die.
They're a chunk of American cultural history.
It was just a special little bit of magic.
We like to call it a time machine because it really transports it, well, at least your ears, back to those shows.
It's unclear why Cash took the gig. In 1967, a drug addiction was killing him and he had attempted suicide. But in 68, everything changed. He kicked the habit, recorded a live album at Folsom Prison, and married singer and songwriter June Carter.
My father, that's one of the most creative years of his life.
John Carter Cash is the only child of Johnny and June. When he first heard the lost recording, he was struck by how it sounded.
I knew there was something specifically different about this show.
The difference involved this man, the legendary sound engineer, Owsley Stanley, also known as Bear.
There's, you know, these two strong personalities and highly creative forces, and they come together over this record.
Bear was the first sound man for the Grateful Dead. He was also a chemist, renowned for making LSD. Grateful Dead historian Dennis McNally.
He made the best LSD when it was legal, also when it wasn't, perhaps.
For Bear, LSD played a role in capturing the perfect sound.
He was trying to put you in the brain of the musician.
Bear's son, veterinarian Starfinder Stanley, explains.
He developed techniques that really captured the sound of a room.
During one acid trip, Bear saw sound waves reverberating around a room. That inspired him to create a sound system that's revolutionary in its approach and clarity.
Owsley's style of recording set the standard for years and years to come.
The ballroom became Bear's laboratory. He recorded the shows in order to study them and improve his method.
He called those tapes his sonic journals.
Cash at the Carousel did not disappoint.
They overtook me down in Juarez, Mexico.
And it sets my father's voice apart. I believe it's probably just as close to what it really would have been like if you were in the room that night.
Bear died in a car crash. His children created a nonprofit foundation in his honor. They are preserving all of their father's old tapes by digitizing them. It's a race against time.
Reel-to-reel tapes are little iron oxide particles glued to plastic. It falls apart, it deteriorates. It's something that we just can't let evaporate.
It's an all-volunteer effort. No one gets paid. So if you buy an album, the proceeds get split between the artists and digitizing the rest of the tapes. Juliet Goodrich, KPIX 5.